So as we await President Biden's address to the nation today to discuss his winter plan to combat COVID, many people have concerns and questions about Omicron. The CDC reporting that this new variant has gone from making up about 13% of cases in the U.S. to 73% of cases in just a matter of days. We're joined right now by former U.S. Surgeon General Jerome Adams. Thank you so much, Dr. Adams, for being with us this morning.
Good morning.
We appreciate your time. And we've seen this variant spread quickly. For those watching at home, it was as though we had never heard of this strain, and then all of a sudden there was mass concern, and now we're seeing the data. But is part of the reason the numbers are so high is we didn't have reporting as to whether the people who were sick with COVID actually had Omicron? Because you had to get tested, and then you had to find out if indeed you had Omicron, correct?
Well, exactly. We weren't doing enough testing. We weren't doing enough sequencing. And that's coupled with the fact that this new variant really is 4 to 5 times more infectious, more contagious than Delta was. And Delta was the most contagious variant we'd encountered thus far. So we really are in a bad situation right now in terms of spread of this virus. And people need to understand that as we go into the holiday season.
Well, when we say bad, it was interesting when Omicron first got on the scene, we were told it would be a couple of weeks before we would have any data on this. And that's pretty much held up. Dr. Fauci initially saying that there was some promising data in regards to Omicron, that the symptoms were not as strong or severe as they were in Delta and other strains. And now we're hearing from medical experts to prepare for deaths and hospitalizations into the winter months. What is your gut telling you about what President Biden will be saying today? He says he's not going to impose a lockdown on the country. What will he do?
Well, I think that I'm hearing that he's going to talk about greater availability of testing, which is important. I was really frustrated with how dismissive Jen Psaki was about increasing testing. I'm hearing now there was a tweet out from Andy Slavitt that the White House is going to be making more testing available. I hope they're opening up testing sites. I hope they're going to be helping hospitals with capacity, because that's what people really need to understand, is we're still going to see this Delta surge filling up hospitals for another 2 to 3 weeks. We're going to see it run the course. And then any cases from Omicron that end up in the hospital on top of that really could be the straw that breaks the camel's back. And then people won't be able to get care for heart attacks, for strokes, for car wrecks. If you're pregnant, there may be no room in the end. And so we need people to understand that's the real urgency of right now.
I'm so glad that you brought this up, because it has seemed to be like we're dealing with foreign, espionage or, intelligence that we shouldn't know because it's bound to the secrets of war. But these are human bodies, and people are looking for answers. So is the biggest concern over Omicron the fact that people are getting sick, and that even if you're asymptomatic, you can still get somebody who might be immunocompromised, a stronger, more dire transmission? Or is it that our hospitals are already maxed out and understaffed, and we're concerned that this is going to be a domino effect with all of the other ailments that people are facing this season?
Well, great question. And it's important for people to understand that we have not seen definitively that this virus is less severe than the Delta variant. What many of us actually believe is that this new Omicron variant is encountering many more people who have immunity, either because they've been vaccinated or because they've been previously infected. And so it appears less severe because it's encountering a different environment than what previous viruses did. Why that's important is because if you're not vaccinated right now, you still could end up in the hospital due to Omicron. And to your point, the real key here is our hospital capacity literally cannot handle anything more on top of this current Delta surge. That's the real fear we have right now, in addition to just wanting to protect as many people as possible, particularly those who are unvaccinated, those who are unboosted.
But, thinking about President Trump, former President Trump, and former Fox News host Bill O'Reilly, they were booed at this event. And again, they weren't booed by a crowd of thousands and thousands of people, but they were criticized by some, according to their revelation about getting the booster shot. But a lot of people are seeing on the news, and we've been reporting it, that there are very mild symptoms. There are people that we know. There are people on social media saying, I got the Omicron variant. I got sick with COVID. I'm better in a day or two. So there's a general question mark as to how severe this could be when you see people who are saying, yeah, I had a fever.
Most of those people are vaccinated. The important point is most of those people are vaccinated or have had prior infection, and that's why it's playing out differently. So people do need to understand the lesson here is what we've always been telling everyone. If you're vaccinated, if you're boosted, that if you've got some degree of immunity, then you're going to be in better shape against any variant that comes along than if you've not been. So the take-home point is get your vaccination.
And a lot of people are still questioning that. I mean, we have about, 60%, 61% of people in the United States have been fully vaccinated. Around 72%, according to the Mayo Clinic, are partially vaccinated. So still driving this point home, is the goal, do you think, as the former Surgeon General of the United States, to have 100% immunity?
Well, we're not going to get to 100% immunity. We haven't gotten there for any vaccine. And we need to remember that prior to COVID, we almost lost our measles eradication status. So even before COVID, we were struggling here. We need to get as many people vaccinated and boosted as we can. We need to paint a picture for people so that they understand what this is going to look like. And I think after everyone gets their third dose of vaccine, we're going to settle into a yearly rhythm the way we do with flu. And just like as with flu, some people get vaccinated. Those who don't may end up in the hospital. We need to get them tested quickly. We need to provide them treatments, and the oral antivirals that are now becoming available need to be pushed out there quickly by the Biden administration. We need to make sure monoclonal antibodies are out there. And we need to help people understand that their underlying health really matters. Making sure you're eating right, making sure you're getting your sleep, making sure you're staying hydrated, making sure you're losing weight if you can going into the new year so that you have resiliency against this variant and any variants that come in the future.
Yeah, a holistic view of health is something that a lot of people, including ourselves right here, need to be focused on. Thank you so much, Dr. Jerome Adams. Really appreciate your expertise and shedding light on this whole story. Appreciate your time.
Thanks, and make sure you get your flu shot too. We're seeing flu surges that are complicating things also. Flu shot, COVID shot, get your booster, protect yourself this holiday season. I care about you more than I care about politics. That's why we want you to do this.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Adams. Appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.